Today we are going to see wrap spinning process. So this is the passage of yarn through the wrap spinning. One here is the roving or the sliver that is being fed. It goes into the drafting system. Then it enters the hollow spindle. There is a continuous filament yarn, which is 4 here, which is coming from a bobbin here, which is rotating on the spindle. This is the spindle, and this is the takeoff roll. It's a very simple passage. The yarn that you finally get here is a two component yarn, and which consists of fibers that you feed here, staple fibers that you feed here through the drafting system. And it will be covered by a filament by twisting. The final yarn that you get here would have no twist in the core, and the filament would be wrapped around it. This is the structure of the wrap spun yarn, and how it exactly happens we'll see in the next slide. This is the passage of both the types of fibers that is being shown. This is the filament. And this is the staple fibers which is coming from the drafting system, which may be any kind of fibers, which we'll see shortly. So the hollow spindle rotates at around 35,000 rpm and is actually behaving like a false twist assembly. Now imagine here when this material is entering here, and what happens is this is the top view of this hollow spindle from here, the way it looks. This fiber strand is made to immediately come out from the left, take a wrap around the spindle and again re-enter at 2 here. So this is from the top. If you see the cross section, it looks like this, and once it goes around the top of the hollow spindle in the form of a wrap here, it is like as if it is gripping here, and this part acts like a false twister for this particular strand. And the material is made to again re-enter the hollow spindle. This is the cross section of the hollow spindle that is being shown. And at the same time, this filament is being fed, which is coming from the bobbin, which is mounted around this in the form of a package around the hollow spindle. So here the fiber strand FA, that is this one, does not pass directly through the spindle. It does not go directly vertically. Instead, shortly after entering the spindle, the strand is laid out again and back around the spindle with a wrap of about 1/4 of the spindle periphery. It is similar to the top of the flyer in case of speed frame, where we take a 1/4 wrap. In this way, as the spindle rotates, the strand is provided with twist between the drafting arrangement and the head of the hollow spindle. So what we get here is there's a drafting system, front roller drafting system somewhere here, and from this region right up to where it is entering the spindle and it is going to come out, here in this area you will have some amount of twist due to the false twisting principle. And this twist is inserted is very important here because it has to, this strand, this fiber, staple fiber strand has to sustain itself till the time that the filament is able to wrap itself around it. So these twists of turns are cancelled out again in the spindle head in accordance with the false twist principle. So as soon as this material will come out of the fall of this grip here, what will happen is the core, that is the staple fibers that we are feeding here, will have no twist in the core which is forming the yarn, and the filament will prevent it from falling apart, because before that it would have wrapped itself around the core fibers which are lying straight. The filament is not false twisted. Now in this case you may ask why the filament is not false twisted, because we must remember that the bobbin is rotating on this hollow spindle itself. It is rotating along with it. So this filament will only wrap itself around this core fibers that are coming in. So what you get is this kind of a bundled yarn. This is how it will look, where the staple fibers are lying straight, which is the set A, and the set B, that is the filaments which are wrapping around the core. So So the yarn wrap yarn consists of two components, twist twist staple fibers core and the filament wound around the core. The yarn that you get by this method is, when you compare it with ring spun yarn, it is more even, as you can see. Strength is also better because in this case what happens is you get the strength both from the parallel orientation of the fibers that is there and also due to the filament yarn that you're going to use to wrap this particular core fibers, and you also have a good cover factor. You can see since the filament is wrapping itself all around, it will have a low hairiness and there will be absolutely no snarling tendency because number of twists that you insert into this yarn is not is only with it's only in the case of the filament where it is only wrapping. There is no actual twist in the core fiber, so there is no hardly any snarling tendency. But what you see is the yarn would look seem to have a slight wave character. It will be slightly wavy here, and this is because the fibers are being bound together by filaments at frequent intervals. And what you get is somewhat similar to an effect yarn. What is an effect yarn? Is a fancy yarn which we shall study in our section 1 later on. So this effect yarn, this would look like as if on purpose you have introduced some kind of texture onto the surface of the yarn. So it is similar to an effect yarn. Also, what you see is there is no need for plying this particular yarn because it has got enough strength, and also sizing can be just skipped before weaving. So both these processes can be eliminated. The field of use is this particular system is commercially known as paraffin and is more suited for long staple spinning. The fibers should be above 60 mm. The filament yarn that is around would be around 2 to 5% of the entire yarn. Filaments produced from all textile polymers are suitable as a wrapping element. For wrapping, you can use any kind of fiber, whether it could be polyamide, polyester, viscose, multi or mono, both. If the final yarn is to consist of only staple fibers, suppose you want only the staple fibers, then what you can do is you can use PVA as the filament for wrapping. And just like if you remember the in Pavina where we used polyvinyl alcohol fibers, here we can use those filaments, and these filaments could be later on dissolved after processing. For medium fine to fine yarns, it would be necessary to use very expensive special filament. In this case of paraffin wrapping, wrap spinning, what you need to do is if you want to produce very fine yarns, final yarns, what you need to do is you need to also use special fine filaments, and which would be very expensive. The high price of the filament relative to staple fibers would increase the costs here. And so economic production of fine yarns using wrap spinning process is not possible. It is possible, but it would incur very high costs, and that's why it is not preferred. This can be used in machine knitting, home and automobile upholstery, woven goods and carpet yarns. So the wrap spun yarns find applications in these areas. When you come to the specification, the spinning positions per machine is 80, delivery speed is 200 meters per minute. Raw material that is used is both the synthetic fibers, which is the core fibers, which would be long staple, of course, 60 to 220 mm. And also you would have a need a filament for wrapping the core. So both these elements are needed. Count range would be, again, we mentioned why we wouldn't be able to go for fine wrap spinning or fine yarns, because the filament cost would rise and people prefer to stay in the coarse count range. The feedstock type would be that is used is drawframe sliver. The type of yarn that is made is filament wrapped single yarn. Yarn characteristic would be high strength, which we have already seen, good evenness. It's a two component yarn. Field of use is carpet, domestic textile, outerwear. Advantages, main advantage is that it has got a fairly low production costs. Special features, separate winding machine needed for filament bobbin. So whatever filament you are using for wrapping, that would probably require a winding machine. So so we come to this chart. We come to this chart where we have completed this particular row, hollow spindle spinning, where it is called as a parafill. The filament is wound on single yarn. Staple fibers are twist free, and twist is inserted by using mechanical wrapping. So now we come to the end, and that was the last slide. Thank you very much.